Hello, it's BrickBros UK, and with all the Avengers Infinity War hype going on recently since the movie trailer release, we thought it would be fun to show you guys how to create some of the heroes in minifigure form from regular parts and pieces, so you can make the whole team or the characters you want in LEGO like we have before the sets even release. Now you might have already spotted that we haven't changed all the minifigures, and this is because many of the heroes in the trailer look exactly the same as their recent set versions. So we kept the Guardians of the Galaxy team, Hawkeye, Falcon, Doctor Strange, War Machine, Nebula, Mantis, and Ant-Man all the same, and we threw in the recent Spider-Man as well, as it's impossible to create his new blue eye mask and metallic suit from regular parts. But we have built 9 of the heroes who have either never been made before in LEGO or needed an Infinity War upgrade. So we'll go through each one to show you who we've made and what we've upgraded, then follow on with the parts and pieces tutorial so you can build them just like we have. So first up, we're starting with Iron Man, and if you've seen the trailer, you would have noticed that his new Mark 48 suit has lots of silver on it with the trademark gold faceplate, which is pretty much an upgrade of his Spider-Man Homecoming Mark 47 suit. So to build this in LEGO, we simply took the gold faceplate, Iron Man helmet and awesome silver legs from the Beware the Vulture set minifigure and put them on the Silver Centurion torso to give our Iron Man a full silver mix from his legs right up to his body, with quality printing on the arms as well, similar to the new Infinity War Mark 48 suit with a triangle in the centre. So as you can see, it's a nice looking substitute Mark 48 Iron Man minifigure, but we might have to improve it once we see more of the movie suit. Next up, one hero who's had a huge appearance change is Black Widow, because she no longer gets to be the ginger-haired assassin, but instead has blonde hair. So to get this style right in LEGO, we opted to use the LEGO Ninjago movie blonde hair from Lloyd, as it seems the right length, plus has the right wavy detail. Now for Black Widow's head, we decided to keep the hero's regular LEGO head, and for her uniform we created a black combat outfit to give the hero a darker design. Then for Black Widow's all-important weapons, we armed the minifigure with 2 black batons which can be clipped to her back for storage, so we've changed up Black Widow quite a lot, but it reflects the same change the movie characters had as well. Captain America also looks different from the last time we saw him, becoming the rogue bearded hero, so to make this Infinity War cap, we put his Civil War torso on backwards to remove the star logo, then we attach black arms with brown gloves and black combat legs below, to make Steve a darker outfit, a bit like Black Widow's. Further up the body, we kept his hair the same, and for the crucial bearded head, we took some time to choose this, and eventually went for Qui-Gon Jinn's from Star Wars, as it has a decent good guy expression, is brown, and goes right round his face just like Cap's beard in the movie. However, if it's not to your liking, you may be able to find a better head choice, but as a whole, we still like our Infinity War Captain America, and we hope you do too. Following on from Captain, it's Thor, who's one of our favourite hero creations because we upgraded the Ultimate Battle for Asgard minifigure by swapping the head and helmet for this awesome bearded one-eye Commander Wolf head with short ginger hair to give Thor the exact same look he has in the new film. And with the scar down the right eye, it's the perfect headpiece to use, plus makes the hero look boss, like a man on a mission. So it's a must build for Thor fans if you can find the wolf head, of course. We also thought Black Panther could do with a maskless upgrade, as he always appears in LEGO sets with his mask on, which is not right. So for the minifigure's black outfit, we attached Death Trooper legs to his Civil War Black Panther pursuit torso to give it detailed printing from top to bottom. Then we armed the hero with Wolverine claws for his weapons and replaced his mask head with Karl Mordo's head and hairpiece, which altogether looks really good with the stubble bearded face, making our minifigure accurate to the movie Black Panther, so it's a simple but effective head swap that's well worth doing. Moving on, we have our minifigure version of Wong to fight alongside Doctor Strange, and this minifigure's design is completely our own due to the hero never featuring in LEGO form before. So we studied the trailer and created these dark red and brown robes with a fabric piece at the bottom from Chirrut Imwe and a tan dark grey detail robe torso from the elemental Ninjago Master Nero, which gives Wong nice sorcerer clothes. Now for a weapon, like Strange, he carries a clear power dish, and for his head we chose the stern grumpy cheekbone face without hair because he has a shaved head in the movie, but you could use a thin black hairpiece if you wanted to. However, as he is, we like this creation of Wong, especially the robes. After Wong, it's our Bruce Banner, who's available in minifigure form in the Battle for Asgard set, so you don't need to change him, but we felt LEGO's minifigure looked way too young. So we ditched his wavy black hair and replaced it with the grey Han Solo one that may be a bit too grey, but it's got the right style. We also kept his awesome green-eyed head from the Ultimate Battle for Asgard set to show his Hulk rage, and below we gave Bruce the black Nick Fury torso with brown legs to create a new casual smart outfit to fit the hero. So altogether, our Bruce has a pretty cool new look, but if you're not keen, you could just use a Hulk figure instead. Next up, we revamped the superhero airport battle set Scarlet Witch by changing her hairpiece to this new brown style one, which to us seems similar to the hair she has in the trailer, and we gave the hero dark blue legs for casual jeans, but that's all we changed. So it's only minimal, but these pieces help to give Scarlet Witch a new Infinity War design. And last but not least, it's the Winter Soldier, who, if we're being honest, hasn't changed much, so we kept the top half the same as the Civil War minifigure, gave him brown legs, and armed him with a custom large gun to give this Infinity War Winter Soldier more firepower, but in fairness, he's not that different. So that completes all of our Infinity War minifigure creations, which were really fun to build, and they nicely go with the other LEGO Avengers and Guardians of the Galaxy characters to make the entire Avengers Infinity War team ready to take on Thanos. Now we admit not all the minifigures have super accurate designs, but considering we just use regular parts and pieces, we're still pleased with how they look. And from the 9 characters, our favourites are Thor with the awesome head, Black Widow and Black Panther, but that's just our pick, so leave a comment below telling us who's your favourite. And if you're eager to make these guys like we have, we can now move on to the tutorial where we'll give you a breakdown of all the parts and pieces you'll need to make each hero. So let's cue the music and get this tutorial started.
Yeah.
And that's the end of the tutorial, which we hope you found useful, so thanks for watching our fun Infinity War minifigure creations video, and we'll see you again soon for more LEGO creations. Hope you enjoyed a Brick Bros UK LEGO creation, and don't forget to check our channel for more of our fun LEGO videos, and like, comment, and subscribe to Brick Bros UK.